welcomes you at Ghare Science Academy, Vidyanagar, Karad. Interactive audio-visual lecture series of physics, chemistry, maths and biology subject for 11th and 12th science students. If you like our lecture series, then please like and subscribe our YouTube channel. Thank you. Welcome in Ghare Science Academy. Now we study about magnetic properties of solids. These magnetic properties are well understood by classical picture of electrons. We studied that electrons are revolving around the nucleus. At that time, they also revolving around their own axis, like Earth. Earth revolving around the sun. At that time, Earth also revolve around itself. Similarly, electrons are revolving around nucleus, and at that time they are also revolving around their own axis. This spinning of electrons act like tiny magnets, and it arises the magnetic field. Spinning action of electrons generate induced magnetic fields. On the basis of magnetic properties, solids are mainly classified into three types, that are diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic. When electrons are paired, then their spins are cancelled with each other and therefore their magnetic moments are zero. And if there are unpaired electrons, then their spins are not cancelled and they show some magnetic moments. On this basis, substances are further classified as diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic. First, we discuss about diamagnetic solids. In diamagnetic solids, all electrons are paired. Therefore, their spins are cancelled with each other and vector sum of their magnetic moment is zero. So the substances which contains all paired electrons and weakly repelled by magnetic field are called diamagnetic substance. For example, N2, F2, NaCl, H2O, etc. Next type are paramagnetic solids. The substances which consist unpaired electrons and weakly attracted by magnetic field are called paramagnetic solids. Paramagnetic solids consist unpaired electrons and they show some permanent magnetic moments. In absence of external magnetic field, magnetic moments are randomly arranged and their net magnetic moment is zero. But when external magnetic field is applied, then they are tries to align with external magnetic field. At the same time, thermal energy opposes to this alignment and therefore some of the alignments are takes place in direction of external magnetic field and they shows magnetism only in presence of magnetic field. If external magnetic field is removed, then they loses their magnetism. For example, oxygen, Cu+2, Fe+3, Cr+3 are paramagnetic substances. They shows magnetism only in presence of external magnetic field. In external magnetic field, they are weakly attracted by magnetic field. Next type is ferromagnetic solids. The substances which consist large number of unpaired electrons and strongly attracted by magnetic field are called ferromagnetic substances. For example, ferromagnetic substances are like iron, cobalt, nickel, iron, which consist four unpaired electron. One unpaired electron interact with other neighboring electrons strongly and align them in same direction, and this group of electrons is called domain, and iron consists large number of such domains. In absence of external magnetic fields, these domains are randomly arranged, and therefore their magnetic moments are cancelled with each other, and resultant magnetic moment becomes zero. While in presence of external magnetic field, they tries to align in direction of external magnetic field, and therefore they shows some strong magnetic moments, and therefore these substances are strongly attracted by magnetic field. In presence of external magnetic field, domains are aligned in direction with magnetic field, and therefore their magnetic moments are not equal to zero. These ferromagnetic substances can be permanently magnetized in presence of external magnetic field, and they can show magnetism even the external magnetic field is removed. For example, iron, cobalt, nickel, gadolinium, CrO2 are ferromagnetic substances.